The International Space Station, like most things, wasn't meant to last forever. Sometime in 2031, the space agency plans to end the ISS's run by crashing it in the middle of the ocean. Why does NASA want to crash the International Space Station into the ocean instead of sending it into space? First, you have to understand why NASA and all the other partners like ESA and JAXA want to get rid of the International Space Station. The ISS began to be built in 1998 through the coupling of several modules launched by the main collaborating agencies. For 24 years, it has suffered the effects of the constant bombardment of micrometeorites, radiation, loose screws, and other small debris from space missions orbiting the Earth and the occasional small docking accident. In addition to the aging of its materials and equipment, which is largely technology that dates back to the 1980s. The ISS is in orbit at about 408 kilometers high, which is not very high. Think of a school globe, locate Dallas and Houston. If you lift the distance between these two cities up, that's just over the height at which the ISS orbits. As you will see, it is quite close to the surface. To maintain that orbit, the ISS has to move at a speed of 28,000 kilometers per hour or else it would fall. Even so, the ISS is continually falling since at that height there is still an atmosphere, although it is very tenuous, and this produces friction that slows down the station. Because of this, the ISS occasionally needs a small push when it drops below a certain height to return to its 408 kilometers orbit. If the ISS did not receive this push regularly, it would end up falling to Earth. The thing is that the ISS is old and expensive to maintain. The value of all the research work carried out during all these years is unquestionable, but the time to retire it and look for a more modern and less expensive replacement is approaching. The same goes for any ship or plane. It has a useful life and there comes a time when it has to be taken out of service. To make a controlled drop on a specific area of the Pacific Ocean where the remains of other ships such as the Skylab Space Station already rest, all you have to do is stop pushing the station back into orbit. Or rather, give it one last push at the right time so that its orbit begins to decay in the calculated way so that it crashes in the scheduled place. To send it into space into a graveyard orbit, a much larger impulse is needed and it is impossible to do with the vehicles available today. A vehicle would have to be designed exclusively for this function, which would be costly and unnecessary. Before crashing into the ocean, the ISS will burn from friction with the denser atmosphere as it descends and will finally fall into the sea in a ball of fire, so that anything you want to rescue from the ISS will have to be removed before being left to its own devices, as there won't even be a black box to salvage afterwards. If you have watched the video so far, I hope you liked it. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel to watch more videos about astronomy and the universe.